Hello and welcome to SciJoy. Today we're at the University Rover Challenge out in Utah at the Mars Desert Research Station. Students from 22 universities and 6 countries arrived in Utah to showcase their rovers at the University Rover Challenge. The annual event is held on the pseudo-Martian terrain at the Mars Desert Research Station. Rovers compete in 4 tasks that test their maneuverability, dexterity, navigation, and scientific prowess. Teams arrive at each task site and set up their robot. NASA controls their Martian vehicles using only the views beamed back from their onboard cameras. This is why the members of our teams are driving robots from inside of U-Hauls. They can use augmented reality devices, game controllers, or anything else that they can think of to control their robot. The rest of the team is allowed to follow the robot as long as they stay out of sight from the onboard cameras. The rovers were asked to assist astronauts. These astronauts were represented by bright orange jumpsuits, and each astronaut required a different tool, so Mission Control was told what each tool was and the GPS coordinates of the astronaut that needed that tool. The rovers could pick up the bright orange signal repeater and move it to a new destination in order to strengthen the signal between the rover and the team in the U-Haul. This was necessary because the rovers had to travel long distances. There were 5 astronauts strewn throughout the desert, and the rovers needed to be able to not only move quickly, but they needed to have a good grasp on where they were in order to assist all of the astronauts before the time ran out. Team's ideas for finding astronauts and transporting the tools ranged from complex laser systems to simple plastic bins. And after they dropped off all the tools, the rovers would have to return to base before their time ran out. We helped run the engineering servicing task. Rovers had to turn knobs and flip switches in particular orders, and then an air pump would turn on and inflate a giant shape behind the bin. The first task that the teams had to accomplish was crossing the road and lining themselves up with a servicing box. The box was made by Protocase and it could take a beating. The rovers needed a good camera placement, grip, and the ability not to get their wires tangled up after 3 turns. After the valves were opened and the levers were flipped, teams hit a light switch and filled up the inflatable behind the box. They watched a pressure dial increase to the proper number and then they flipped the light switch off again. The terrain traversal task was held in the HAB. Mission Control was inside of the building and teams had to drive through 8 different posts, and these posts increased in difficulty as the rover moved on. We made teams climb higher and higher up mountains and cross further and further distances. And they weren't even climbing on regular dirt. The soil was very difficult to grip, and there are many interesting ideas that teams came up with to combat the unique terrain. As teams raced to make it through all the posts, we found ourselves frequently running out of sight from the robot's onboard cameras. And since Mission Control can only see what's happening through the eyes of their cameras, they didn't always know the state of their robot. This meant that teams would have to call for interventions. They would lose some points, but they were at least able to get their robot up and working again. There was also a ROP we created for the rovers to navigate through, and there was a nice stretch of rock garden too. The cell site was home to the scientific portion of the competition. It was the sample return task site. Teams had to survey the landscape, take photos, obtain soil samples, and perform analysis on the samples they collected. They would attach special equipment for drilling, collecting samples, and scientific instruments in order to perform experiments onboard the rover. The rover would drive around looking for a site of interest. The judges had placed things that didn't belong in this terrain, and when Mission Control deemed an area important, they would start to drill. Soil samples could be stored onboard the rover and brought back to the U-Haul in order for team members to analyze using lab equipment they had brought. The teams would then explain to the judges what they saw, what they took photos of, and why they decided to drill in certain locations. And if they saw any signs of water, they'd be sure to point it out to the judges in their slideshow. We had a wonderful time out in Utah getting to see all the different rovers that everyone had built. And we will have a few more videos from our adventures, including this robot right here that is climbing over these people, attempting to climb to the top of a mountain. And remember, you can talk to us in the comments below on Twitter, Facebook, Tumblr, Instagram, and Reddit. And as usual, remember, keep exploring.